Jezus, nee joh. Gaat gewoon mensen dood aan. Wat een enge man. Dat zijn echt gestoorde mensen, ouwe. Ik ben heel bang momenteel. Ik weet niet hoe het met jullie zit. Ik ben bang.
Zes meest verontrustende boservaringen op camera. Het is weer zover. Tijd voor een reactievideo. Ik heb eigenlijk niet zo'n zin om bang te zijn. Ik begon met opnemen en ik dacht, shit, ik moet het nu gaan kijken. Het is s'avonds laat. Maar goed, weet je, you know the deal. Ik kijk het samen met jullie en zo. En blablabla. In ieder geval, meer dan 60% van de mensen die deze video kijkt, is nog niet geabonneerd op dit kanaal. Ik zou het maar even doen. Laat ik het zo zeggen. Ik wacht wel even. Oké, dankjewel. Oh, the rain.
YouTuber from the UK with a channel called English Woodsman, where he's been uploading videos of his wild camping, stealth camping, and woodland camping trips in the UK for almost 10 years. Most of the channel's videos feature Daniel reviewing camping gear for his viewers and showing footage of his adventures in the great outdoors. For the most part, they're pretty tame, but in August 2023, he uploaded a video.
Hij zit echt niet diep in het bos. Ik zie daar letterlijk gewoon maar de stad. Dit is gewoon naast een weiland. Ik heb het gevoel dat hij gewoon langs de weg is gelopen. Verder haat ik absoluut niet. Zeker niet. Ik zou het zelf ook niet doen, maar het ziet er niet heel wild uit.
A video of his camping trip in the woodlands close to his home, and the footage is pretty disturbing. The first part of the video pretty much just shows Daniel walking through the woods and talking to his subscribers, eating berries and pointing out the sights on the way to the campsite.
Ik moet ook zeggen dat altijd als je deze video's begint met kijken, dan heb je gewoon geen idee wat er gaat gebeuren. Letterlijk alles kan. Het kan een beer zijn, een of andere enge man, een geest, een boom die valt, whatever. Alles kan.
At several points along the way, he pauses to mention the footprints and garbage he sees lying on the trail, indicating other people had been there in the last few days.
Someone's been here. There's a lot of rubbish around here. Yeah, look at the state of this.
Yeah.
It does get used, doesn't it?
After about a 20-minute walk, he sits down in a clearing where he plans to set up camp for the night and leans back on a tree to eat his noodles as he talks to the camera. It's not until around 25 minutes into the video that things start to get seriously disturbing for Daniel.
And rain camping is really good.
Die voetstappen klinken best wel nep of zo. Ik ben heel bang momenteel. Ik weet niet hoe het met jullie zit. Ik ben bang.
Is dat een badger? Hallo?
Maar waar komt het vandaan? Huh? Beetje raar.
Even though some pretty human-like footsteps could be heard right behind Daniel, as soon as he turns around to scan his environment, there's nobody in sight. What's most disturbing is that as soon as he turned around and yelled hello, the footsteps immediately stopped. For the next few minutes, he sits down and tries to regain his composure.
Kijk, als die voetstappen opeens stoppen, dat betekent niet dat hij is weggelopen, dat betekent dat hij zich verstopt en er nog steeds is. Anders hoorde je wel iemand wegrennen.
As he sips his coffee and eats his noodles, but things only continue to get even more creepy as the sun begins to set.
There's that noise again now. Hello?
Oh, ik ben bang.
Hello? You got a bit of that.
No. Je hoort toch ook een soort stem in de verte, of ben ik nou gek?
About 40 minutes into the video, the footstep noises can be heard again. And this time, it sounds like they're getting closer to Daniel. By this point, most people would have hightailed it out of there without any hesitation, but Daniel decides to sit back down to finish his dinner as he tries to calm his nerves for the second time.
Ik was ook wel weggegaan nu.
Amazingly, a few minutes later, it almost seems like he completely forgets about the footsteps and manages to think about less disturbing things, which is honestly pretty impressive. But as darkness sets in, the eerie footsteps start up again.
Oh, maar, hebben we niet al eerder een keer een video van deze gozer gezien? Dat hij ook in het bos... Was hij dat niet? Of... Ben ik nou gek?
I'm gonna be honest. I can't stay here now. I'm gonna be a wimp. I don't care if people call me a wimp in the comments. But...
Hij ligt ook letterlijk onder de open lucht. Gewoon onder een slaapzak in het gras. Dat is toch niet eens meer survival eigenlijk? Wat is de lol daarvan?
I can't stay here. I'm too unsettled. I'm nervous. I've done camping like this load of times. I think I'm gonna go find somewhere else to get this bivvy set up. But I'm leaving this spot.
Understandably, after this third incident, Daniel decides to head somewhere else for the night to play it safe. It's hard to...
Eerlijk, ik kan me wel goed verplaatsen in hoe die zich voelt. Ik heb ook wel eens dat ik alleen... Tenminste, dat we dan ergens aan het ghosten zijn of zo. Dat je dan alleen bent, weet je wel, eventjes. En dat is zoveel enger dan als je met mensen bent. Dat is zoveel enger.
To know what exactly was making those sounds. But because they sounded very similar to human footsteps, it's possible that Daniel was being stalked by someone in the woods. This is obviously incredibly dangerous, as you can never really trust someone's intentions when you're in such a vulnerable position, all by yourself in unknown territory. It was either that or an animal walking through the grass, but because Daniel mentioned the grass was a little wet and wouldn't have made that dry sound if an animal stepped on it, this is pretty unlikely. Also, many people in the comments mentioned that no animal walks that uniform and steady. They stop, go, and change pace constantly. Either way, it's a good thing he decided to leave, because who knows what could have happened to Daniel that night.
Klinkt al raar of zo. Het klonk ook een beetje... Het klonk ook een beetje nep of zo. Ja, ik wil niet zeggen dat het nep is, maar het klonk wel gewoon gek. Als je die voetstappen hoort en er is niet iets dat je kan zien, ja, ik weet het niet. Ik vond het raar.
The Rampant Range is part of a front range of the Rocky Mountains in Colorado, made up of almost entirely public land within the Pike National Forest. In the summer, you'll find lots of bikers enjoying the Rampant Range's elaborate trail system and exploring the great outdoors. For the most part, this part of Colorado is a paradise for anyone who enjoys spending time in nature. But over the past few years, there's been a pretty alarming trend on the rise, with random people setting up wires on trees at just about head height in an effort to seriously injure bikers on the trail.
Oh shit, het is net zo'n verhaal als met die kwad die ene keer. Dat er zo'n lijn is gespannen. En ze er dan doorheen rijden dat je dan zo wap dat ding door je nek krijgt.
In 2019, a post describing this terrifying trend was uploaded to Facebook. And disturbingly, the uploader mentioned that one of his high school friends had lost his life as a result of running into a similar wire on a trail.
Jezus, nee joh, gewoon mensen dood aan.
Immediately, people jumped into the comments to point out how incredibly messed up it would be to do something like this, and how this kind of evil needs to be categorized as attempted murder if the suspects are ever caught. A couple of years before that post was made, in 2017, two motorbike riders uploaded a video to YouTube of their encounter with a similar wire, and although nothing happened to them, it was a very close call.
Whoa. Good call. Deze zie je ook wel goed hangen, moet ik zeggen. Ja, dat is wel messed up hoor. Eerlijk.
When these wires are set up off trail, it can be hard to tell whether they were placed there out of malice or if a random camper or farmer placed the wires there to hang up clothes or something similar. But in cases like these where the wires are specifically placed on the trail, there's really only one reason people would do that, and that's to bring serious harm to bikers for some reason.
En mensen die haten op van die bikers als ze veel geluid maken en zo.
Possibly they're annoyed with the constant loud sound of the bikes near their property. Precies. Or something else. But hopefully more measures can be taken in the future to prevent more people from getting hurt, especially because...
Zo, dit is wel een mooie trail trouwens. Wat is dit, joh? Lijkt me echt leuk.
Because it's not uncommon to hear about motorbikers and snowmobilers losing their lives over this kind of stuff. This audio was uploaded to YouTube by a user named Forest Fire number 21. He recorded it around 2 a.m. in December 2014. The uploader lives in a forest, and he mentioned that the noises in the audio were coming from deep in the woods behind his house.
Maar wacht even hoor, want Liep hij al in dat bos en hoorde hij toen dat? Of hoorde hij het vanuit zijn huis en ging hij toen kijken in het bos wat het was? Zegt hij daddy? Is het daddy?
It's hard to make out what the child is yelling, but after listening closely, several users jumped in the comments to point out that you can also hear an adult voice yelling, "Where are you?" In addition to the young female voice making most of the noise,
Sorry, ik was even die comments aan het lezen bezig. Ik zat in een soort trance, ik zat die comments aan het lezen. Sorry.
This quieter, more subtle male voice that can also be heard in the audio only makes the whole incident that much more disturbing.
Wacht, dat hoorde ik niet. Gaat hij dat nog laten horen?
Near the end of the video, the uploader mentions that after that night, he checked the news every day to see if he could find some explanation for the screams, but he never did. The fact that the screaming was captured at around 2 a.m. in the freezing cold weather and in the middle of the woods indicates that the uploader could have genuinely recorded something pretty sinister taking place that night. It's hard to tell why the uploader would record and upload the audio instead of immediately calling the police after hearing a female voice in such obvious distress, but...
Was het een female voice? Klonk hier gewoon als een kind. Zou ook gewoon een jongetje kunnen zijn, toch?
At this point, there's not much that can be done about it. And who knows, maybe the uploader did call the police. There wasn't much context given in the video's description.
Oké, tot nu toe... wel een beetje vreemde dingen, maar nog niks echt... daadwerkelijk heel eng. Althans, ja, hoe kan je dit verklaren? Je hebt ook vaak dat mensen zeggen dat coyotes en zo ook van die rare geluiden kunnen maken. Je zou ook een soort van jankende kat, maar een katachtig kunnen zijn. Zo. Nee, ik moet het ook niet doen trouwens. Maar zoiets zou kunnen, toch? Ik bedoel, who knows?
Lisa is a life coach and YouTuber who often uploads videos of what it's like living in her van and traveling the country on her own. One afternoon in 2022, Lisa had parked her van on the side of the road and left the side door of her van open while she cooked her dinner inside.
Eén ding wat ik wel heb geleerd van deze video is dat er echt veel meer mensen zijn die dingen in hun eentje doen en overnachten en whatever dan ik dacht. Ik dacht het zijn alleen een paar mafkezen die gewoon af en toe in hun eentje ergens gaan liggen of zo. Maar je hebt gewoon fucking veel mensen die gewoon in hun eentje reizen en zo en in een bos gaan slapen. Like, why would you do that?
When suddenly a sketchy-looking guy approached her, poked his head in her van without her permission, and started asking her some pretty bizarre questions in French, a language Lisa doesn't speak. When she mentioned she didn't understand what he was saying, he pulled out a translator app to try to communicate with her. After watching the guy struggle to use Google Translate for a few minutes, Lisa decided she'd had enough and shut the side door in his face, also closing the curtain to make sure the guy got the hint. Strangely, for over half an hour, the guy then stood outside in the rain and tinkered with the translator app to try to communicate with Lisa, even after she made it more than obvious that she wanted nothing to do with him.
Stel je voor, hè? Die gozer die wilde gewoon langs met zijn auto, maar het kan niet. Dus we doen het in de regen wachten, want zei ik dat hij hem wilt verkrachten of zo. Wat een enge man. Wat doet hij? Waar gaat hij heen? Was dat niet zijn auto?
So that I can't move out, so that I can't go forward.
Oh, hij heeft zijn auto er neergezet. Wat een rare gast.
Please leave. Please leave, you sketchy person. Please leave.
Maar wacht even, waarom bel je dan niet de politie op dit moment, toch?
With a very shady demeanor, the man snuck into the bushes and pretty much just stalked Lisa from a distance, as if he thought she couldn't see him. As the sun began to set, Lisa kept an eye on the guy outside to make sure he didn't try to get close to her again, but the man just kept on bringing his car closer to her van and blocking her exit in different ways for more than half an hour.
This guy is really starting to freak me out. It's been like a half an hour and he just keeps on moving his vehicle so he can see in my van here. And anyways, it's 7 o'clock, 7 p.m.
Hoe lang ging dit door?
Just as darkness had begun to set in, a family in an RV pulled up right behind Lisa and spent the night in the same parking lot as her, which comforted her enough to stay there the entire evening.
Oh, that's all chill, yeah.
Disturbingly, the guy left soon after the other family arrived, but came back about 3 hours later in the dead of night to check if Lisa was still there. When he saw the other family in the RV was also still in the parking lot, he left and didn't come back.
Maar hoe weten we dit dan? Heeft u dat ook gezien?
The next morning, Lisa left early and never saw the guy again. It's hard to tell what the guy's exact intentions were, but based on his overall sketchy demeanor and questionable behavior, they couldn't have been anything good.
Nee, wat een enge man.
The one thing we can be sure about is that it's a good thing the other family in the RV arrived at the parking lot when they did. Otherwise, who knows what the man would have done to Lisa.
Kijk, ik moet zeggen, zij heeft heel lang afgewacht. Ik denk, ja, als ik in haar positie had gezeten, had ik waarschijnlijk gewacht tot die gast heel dicht bij de deur stond en gezegd van, kom nog iets dichterbij. En dan in één keer zo, boah, klap ik zo die deur open en hij wordt zo door de deur geraakt en poeh, smash zo naar achter. En als ik het goed zag, is daar achter een meertje. En omdat hij zo hard wordt geraakt, wordt hij als een plank zo over het water geschoten. En op dat moment ren ik er achteraan en spring ik zo op zijn lichaam en gebruik ik zijn lichaam als het ware als een soort surfboard om over het meer heen te surfen. En dan surf ik zo in één keer rechtsaf naar het politiebureau, waar ik dan salto van hem af zou maken en hem zo op mijn schouder mee zou nemen en zeggen van, hier, alsjeblieft meneer de agent, deze guy is een enge stalker en hij mag nooit meer vrijkomen. Maar goed, dat is wat ik zou doen, ik weet niet. Ik snap wel dat je dat niet meteen bedenkt om te doen ook.
In May 2014, an Imgur user uploaded a blog post where he talked about the time he went to visit a friend in northern Germany. According to the uploader, his friend told him about these pipes that he had found in the woods near his house that stuck up out of the ground like periscopes.
Ik weet wat dit zijn. Dit zijn toch in principe dingen, luchtpijpen voor bunkers. Als je een bunker onder de grond hebt, zodat er lucht bij kan komen. En die zijn op een gegeven moment zo naar beneden gaan gemaakt worden, zodat je er geen granaten in kon gooien naar beneden. Dat is helemaal echt waar. Trust me.
Apparently, his friend and his siblings played near the pipes as kids and knew that there were bunkers hidden below them, but their parents never allowed them to get near them out of concern for their safety. During the visit narrated in the blog post, the uploader and his friend decided to check out the pipes and finally go down into the bunkers that they never had permission to explore when they were younger.
Oh shit, wel mooi gefilmd trouwens, lekker met zo'n stabilizer en zo.
And they found some pretty disturbing stuff. A few hundred feet
Bunkers blijven ook altijd creepy, man. Ik zweer het.
Away from the trees, they found the entrance to the bunker covered with a loosely placed piece of wood that they easily removed with a crowbar. Once inside, all they could see were these long, seemingly endless, hospital-like hallways that extended for thousands of feet under the woods.
What? Zo groot?
As they ventured further and further into the...
Er zijn nog niet zoveel mensen geweest. Er zijn geen graffiti en zo. Ze hebben niet kapot. Geen zand ligt in. Dat maakt het altijd enger nog.
In the maze of tunnels, they found graffiti on some of the walls, indicating they weren't the first people to get the idea to explore the underground bunkers. To the explorer's horror, one of the walls deep inside the tunnels had the word help in German graffitied all over it. It's possible that it was just sprayed on there by another group of teens trying to be funny, but the eerie nature of the bunker coupled with the general state of disarray really makes you wonder if something more sinister took place down there at some point.
Nee, dat zijn gewoon mensen die een beetje lopen te kloten. Dat doen ze altijd. Ik zweer het.
Possibly even written by German soldiers in the later parts of World War II. As they traveled deeper into the bunker, they found some more disturbing graffiti, with one of the eeriest messages reading, "Hello Satan, I love you." Obviously, that's not the kind of message you want to see in a tunnel system like this, but the two friends...
Nee, klopt, maar dat is gewoon gekke gothic die naar beneden rondlopen. Jipje.
...and decided to keep on exploring anyway. After several hours down in the bunker, they ended up finding tons of more twisting, winding hallways, flooded rooms with old machines, and dark, narrow corridors that reached dead ends. But nothing more disturbing than the graffiti they had found a few hours earlier.
Was dat het? Ik vond deze vond ik serieus niet eng. Ik bedoel, bunkers zijn daadwerkelijk wel eng, maar ik ben zelf ook genoeg geweest, er zijn altijd rare dingen. Dit is niet zo eng.
In 2016, reports started surfacing that people were finding dangerous booby traps along a very well-known hiking trail in the High Mountain Park Preserve in Wayne, New Jersey.
Jesus, we do that now.
As per the police reports, the traps mostly consisted of boards with nails sticking out of them, barbed wire, broken bottles placed along the trails behind or near rocks or logs, and other treacherous materials.
Dat zijn echt gestoorde mensen, ouwe. Je hebt er ook zelf helemaal niks aan. Je bent er niet eens bij als er iets gebeurt.
As more and more complaints started...
Oh, die is wild, hè. Die is wild.
Coming in, police warned people to keep an eye out for the traps and even organize cleanup efforts to keep hikers safe during their treks. What's most disturbing is that these traps were clearly placed there to hurt people, as there's really no other reason to put nails and barbed wire on the ground in the middle of such a popular hiking trail.
Yeah, what a noob, huh?
The fact that someone would take the time to get out on the trail, build a booby trap in such detail, and place it there with the intention to do harm to other people and their pets is honestly pretty messed up. But it didn't take the cops too long to make an educated guess as to who was behind the whole thing.
Oh, wie was het dan?
Although they never found the individual suspects responsible for placing the traps on the trail, the sheriff's department determined that the traps had probably something to do with the feud between hikers and bikers who had been fighting over use of the trail for decades.
Hikers and bikers?
According to many nearby residents, it's common for bikers on the trail to speed past the hikers without ringing their bells or announcing their presence, which has led to several injuries and rising tensions between the two groups over the years.
Hey, Jezus, wat een gehannes, man. Doe gewoon normaal.
Still, it's hard to imagine that someone would take the issue to the point of trying to harm an entire group of people so maliciously with such brutal methods. Fortunately, no one was hurt as a result of the traps, but the suspects responsible were never found.
Yo, that's crazy, man. Ik moet zeggen, dit was wel spannend. Ik vond het zeker niet de meest spannende. Dit was de minst spannende tot nu toe. We hebben echt veel spannendere dingen gehad, waar ik nu wel blij om ben. Want ik ben zelf, het is best wel eng hier. Volgende keer gaan we een hele enge kijken. Abonneer eventjes. Later.